I saw that Jeffery Dahmer was trending related to the recently released Netflix video and didn't really care much about it until I read comments on one of the live court videos from his trial. The comment section was filled with people saying how gross and disgusting he was for what he did. How could someone do something like this, etc. In psychology and esoteric spirituality, the theory has often been explored if humans are inherently good. However, the Gnostic knows they are not. The Gnostic knows that humans are not inherently good. When we look back at stories from the Old Testament concerning Cain and Abel and the creation of our world, we discover that our world was created by a lesser god, the Demiurge, as known in Gnosticism. A similar comparison to the Demiurge in Haitian Voodoo is beings like Metcalfour. The god of the Old Testament required human and animal sacrifice from many biblical characters, starting with Cain and Abel. When you work with spirits, they are supposed to change the way you view the world. The Loa I deal with forced me to view the world in a different way, the way the world is, not how it should be. And today I am going to explain Dahmer, serial killers in general, and Western sickness from a voodoo and Gnostic point of view. Our existence on the Tree of Life is represented by the sphere of Malakuth, the lowest Sephiroth on the Tree of Life. Just below us is Kapoth and what encompasses the Tree of Death. Both trees were byproducts of the creation process, or Big Bang. Because our existence on the Tree of Life is so close to beings that exist on the tree below us, the Tree of Death, we are influenced significantly by it in a negative way. The vibration and energy that emanates from the Tree of Death affects our physical and astral spaces and can be viewed by those who have successfully developed their astral senses. All beings require energy to live, and beings associated with Kapoth and the realms below require a certain type of energy to sustain vitality. The type of energy they require is associated with sin in Christianity. Typically, when you hear of mass shootings, serial killers, or persons losing control of themselves and doing such and can't remember what they did, this is typically from possession or influence of the beings from the lower spheres, attempting to acquire energy. These spirits jump in or influence the animal mind of the person, and the person then acts on their instincts or influence. The being is fed, and the person is left to deal with the consequences. The importance of having lunar spirits such as Loa is because they act as a spiritual immune system or line of defense against the forces that influence our world. When you are disconnected at a lunar level, you are more susceptible to negative forces because you have no protection. Your mind can then be influenced and used without your knowledge. People often talk about demons and demon possession. However, this is not as common as people make it seem. Demons will only possess a person who has a significant amount of spiritual energy and is unaware, further proving the importance of lunar spirits. Serial killers and Jeffrey Dahmer can be viewed by the Gnostic as persons or beings who represent our true animal nature. The animal mind is at the base of the skull in the human and is leftover remnants of our early animal ancestors. This is represented by the moon card in the tarot. In science, this part of the brain is represented by the brainstem and cerebellum. The brainstem and cerebellum are what controls the basic automatic functions of the body, like breathing. The animal mind is sometimes referred to as the reptilian brain in some sects of spirituality. In nature, animals that function on a base level of instinctual consciousness are animals such as crocodiles who, for example, will eat their own young to simply control the population of their species. Without spirituality, many or most humans are functioning at this level of consciousness associated with the instincts in our animal minds. Then society tries to mask this part of ourselves through rules, morals, and religion without transforming our animal natures. The animal mind is something that must be spiritually transformed in the human being to evolve beyond this. Much of the Cain prototype's behaviors can be broken down using occult psychology with an understanding of the animal mind. The door to the animal mind for persons like Dahmer is left open. Cain prototypes submit to their instincts or animal minds instead of understanding them and transforming them. Jeffrey Dahmer and serial killers in general represent a Western sickness that stems from the sexual repression and conforming to societal norms. This repression creates personality shells out of people like those seen in American Psycho, Patrick Bateman, or the Joker prototype from Batman. When one understands the animal nature of the man and woman, one can begin to transform this energy. The man in his base level of animal functioning is concerned with the spreading of his seed. At a base level, women are concerned with survival. Dahmer and people like him make a choice to let the lower forces or world possess them, and once they have crossed a certain threshold, it will take them over completely. Baron Criminal in Haitian Voodoo is said to be the first person to commit a murder for a specific group of people and was made a loa, similar to Cain from the Bible. Baron Criminal is associated with Zoes and underworld activities. In the Bible, it is known that many of us are descendants of Cain and that his murderous ways were passed down ancestrally. In Gnosticism, they attempt to transform the Cain DNA to Abel DNA through inner alchemy. The building of cities is attributed to Cain and allows for the concentration of sin in an area. The Gnostic knows that the formation of cities allows for the concentration of energy required to feed the lower worlds and is created by humans functioning at an animal level. It is also important to note that Baron Criminal is synchronized with Saint Pancras, and more importantly, that Saint Pancras is also a city in London. You may be thinking, Voodoo Diaries, this is all about psychology and not about voodoo at all. Well, the criminal mind, or mind of those who function on that vibration, such as serial killers, is a human condition. Baron Criminal was once a human. Cain was once a human. Jeffrey Dahmer was a human. This is all psychology because this is the human condition associated with the fall of man and the formation of our world. And until we transform ourselves, what exists within Dahmer exists within us. Until next time.